Now, after a three-day weekend like the one we've just had, it can be hard to give it 100% at work, but there are some Kiwis who put the rest of us to shame with their dedication to the job.
A supermarket shelver in Wellington is blowing people away with the way he makes all the stuff in the supermarket aisle look absolutely perfect. Julian Lee had a hankering to meet the man who's turned a traditionally low-skilled job into an art form.
Perfection can be applied to anything. Art is willpower.
Beautiful. Yeah.
And even something as simple as a potato chip aisle in a supermarket can be turned into a thing of beauty.
It's kind of like a showcase, I guess, when people see it. So, you know, they walk past and they see it and, you know, they appreciate it as well. But for us, this is something we just do on a daily basis, not just here, but all around the shop. It's just the standard we hold.
The chips are so straight, people actually apologise when they take a bag.
They see you facing it up, making it look nice, and then they just come and whoop, take one out, and then they're like, no, sorry, and they're like, no, it's all right.
Something so simple, yet already getting heaps of attention on social media. Pio's not the only one who arranges the chips, but he's probably one of the most experienced. Unsurprisingly, he's now worked his way up to management.
Do you find it a little boring, or to be straightening up chips all the time, or do you find it interesting?
Really, because it's actually satisfying.
Yeah. And of course, it's just such a great opportunity for young people to see an industry that's there that they can grow into. The old saying is, not where you start, it's where you finish.
This is where Gary started too, on the shelves. By 24, he had his first supermarket. I get the feeling there is something going on here.
In your personal life, would you classify yourself as a perfectionist?
I would say yes. Fortunate enough, I was introduced to martial arts, so with martial arts, it's all about the excellence.
Basically, how do you do it?
I can show you if you want.
So you sort of bring it to the front.
Yeah. Even though sometimes the chips isn't like really full behind, if we face it well enough, it gives that impression that it's really full. Yeah, that's the OCD kicking in.
How would you rate that, all right?
That's a two. That's a 2 out of 10.
The technique is complex.
Wow. Far out. Did someone teach you this?
Yeah, or someone taught me that, yeah.
Someone taught you how to do it?
Yeah, it's been passed down from generations.
Yeah.
Like if you do a good puff, it kind of like does 80% of the work, I'd say. When you pull up, it doesn't shift around, you kind of hook it.
Is your house like this as well?
You know it is.
Is it?
What you did yesterday, you must do better the next day, right? It's called the pursuit of excellence. Luckily enough for us and the staff, I mean, they can see that and it creates opportunity for them because they get better.
A reminder that when we take pride in what we do, whatever it is, we inevitably reap the benefits. Insurance against the chaos which surrounds us.
That's terrible. Oh my gosh, those shelves were so beautiful.
Pio's amazing.
So beautiful. I try to do that occasionally in the pantry and then it just turns into a mess.
Mm.
I do have, you know, the baked beans all stacked up together and the tomato sauces and the little bits and pieces like that.
I can see you doing that actually. No, I don't go with the labels facing forward. However, when it comes to lawns, obviously different than products and shelves, but lawns, I love to get a good line going on. Mm-hmm. Nothing better than straight lines and lawns.
I can understand that.
Feels so good. Coming up. Yeah.